Hey there guys, welcome back again to my series of videos about Real Racing 3. So today I'm going to show you how to win a multiplayer game. So a lot of people have been worrying that even if they have a fully upgraded car, they are constantly being overtaken, and that they couldn't win in spite of many factors. So many people have been in a draw. I have got many comments and many posts regarding that they are not going off track, they are not going and hitting some other cars, but still their multiplayer points are going down. So today I'm gonna explain you why, on what factors exactly these multiplayers are depending. So why I need to tell you the factors is that once you understand on what factors your multiplayer points are going are based on, so you will you might concentrate on those particular terms. So let's go ahead and see. The first thing you have to remember about multiplayer game is that don't give any kind of shit about your car going and hitting to other car, going off road or cutting the lane. Yeah, cutting the lane is a factor where your car speed decreases and maintains at certain limits and that you cannot pick up the speed and win the race. Fine, that's a factor to be kept on the mind. But you going and hitting a car, going off road doesn't decrease your multiplayer points at all. So what I mean to say is, people thinking that going off-road and hitting other cars might decrease your multiplayers. No, hitting other cars and taking the speed down is completely okay. That's another factor where you can win this game with. The second thing you have to keep in mind is multiplayer has an option called Slipstream, or rather a property of Real Racing 3 multiplayer, Slipstream. So what exactly is this Slipstream? Slipstream allows you to gain an additional extra speed than your original speed and original time or acceleration. So what you have to do to gain a slipstream? There is nothing much you have to do to gain a slipstream. All you have to do is to keep your car 5 yards to 10 yards right behind your opponent car to gain the slipstream. So say you and your opponent have the same performance rating, and you need not worry that you might not take over that car. There's nothing like that. All you have to do is gain an extra speed with the property called slipstream. So you just have to put your car right behind the other car, right behind your opponent car, or from 5 yards to 10 yards of distance, or closer than that, whichever is okay. You just have to maintain that distance and your car will definitely gain some extra speed and some extra acceleration, which you can easily win this race. So that's the most and the main property where all the races, where all the multiplayer races uses it to gain an extra speed and win over other races. So it's better even if you use the same property. So this is what lane cutting exactly is. So you have to better avoid this. I'm not gonna win this race, I'm sure about it, just because I have cut the lane. I'm gonna go quit this race and I'm gonna show you it in the next race how to do it. Sorry for this inconvenience, but still that's okay. I have told you some tips, you better follow that and you're definitely gonna win. The only thing you have to put in mind is that do not give any shit about your car appearance, you're going off road and you hitting other car and getting your car damaged. that's not at all gonna help you in any way. The only factor that's gonna help you is do not cut the lane, do not take any kind of shortcut, and try to possess as much as slipstream as you can. That's the main factors where real racing 3 depends on. So here we enter into the race. And the another factor that you must keep in mind is that it's better if you always keep your car fully upgraded. Yes, I mean it's better if you always keep your car fully upgraded, because everyone taking part in the real racing 3 will definitely have their car upgraded. So I'll show you how a slipstream works. So this is it, how I gained an extra speed over that car, and how that car just passed me, gained an extra speed over me. I'm definitely sure that our both performance ratings are one and the same. So some other factors where real racing 3 depends on is how you take a particular turn. Make sure while taking a turn you reduce the speed of your car so that you gain a bit of extra speed or maintain the speed while picking it up back. So this is it guys, all you have to keep in mind. The first property is that slipstream. The second thing is that do not give a shit about how you are hitting other cars and getting, and the third thing is that do not cut the lanes and reduce your speed and get your speed cut. And remember to decrease the speed of your car at some critical turns, which will help you to keep your speed up. Well, my opponent seems like he's a bit more experienced than me. His way of taking turns is just awesome. Or rather, they both are under constant slipstream. So they could maintain a big distance between me, even though my performance rating is as equal as those cars. So this is it guys, thanks for watching. I hope this tutorial will be helping you in your future game.